He was trying to fuck on me.
Hey, I'm an innocent bystander, but I cannot see. I'm legally blind. That's my story. I'm sticking to it. I'm innocent.
With the wind in her arms.
Fuck on me. Fuck on me. Fuck on me. Fuck on me.
Ted Jr. blows by.
Out on Moxley, sending him hard into the barricade, excuse me, the ring steps, and now the stomp. Moxley returned to the ring.
What you got, Tony?
See, smart veteran right there, going for a cover. He knows Moxley. Sorry, what's Shivani up to? He's got another note. Who's he talking to? Somebody. I mean, how often do you talk to Tony Khan on during these broadcasts?
You know, just watch the match, dude.
I am watching. Dude, I'm calling the friggin' match. Oh, tell me, watch the match. I'm calling it. Watch the match, dude. Kiss my ass, dude.
Piss me off now.
Dude, me.
Firing.
Jump over Excalibur, wear you out. Got me hot now.
Are you going to get a double knee replacement first before you jump over me?
I have adrenaline. It hurts, though.
Well, so does John Moxley.
Oh, that was a great
He's going to need
Damn it, Shivani. Don't do that to me. He's got the hammer lock. He's got the rear chin lock. Man.
John Moxley.
Oh, look at that, dude. I work for him now. Jeez. Mox is in trouble.
We're going to have a hard reset in about 10 seconds.
Thank yeah, God.
I hope so.
Hey,
what?
Oh, it's Sanjay.
What the hell are you doing?
You Sanjay.
Oh.
Oh. Sanjay. Dutt just
went off.
Oh, no.
Nice fucking model.
And also on our countdown show, later on, Corey and I will head to ringside. We have the opportunity to call a match for the Women's Tag Team Championship. Bianca Belair, and of course, Cora Jade will defend against,
Jade Cargill.
Cargill,
lots
got ahead of myself,
plenty
against
of
Candice LeRae and Indy Hartwell for the tag titles later on tonight here on the Countdown Show. Too much social media.
You were always on my mind.
Well, tonight the leaders of both respective groups go at it. Rey Mysterio, the Hall of Famer, versus the World Heavyweight Champion, Damian Priest. Damian Priest, it's live, and it's next. It's been a long day.
You're telling me.
Briggs is looking for just that one big win, Vic, to take him to that next level, endorsed by one future Hall of Famer, JBL.
Well, certainly so, and he saw Wesley get pushed away.
Excuse me, Hall of Famer, my
bad. You screwed it up, not me. I'm not the one that's going to get a phone call. That's going to be you.
Later.
I say the only reason that Booker T was WCW champion was because I was not in WCW. I have always been, and I will always be better than Booker T.
Zoom!
Going to the hooky-la.
lap. The hooky, 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 hooky lap. Everybody loves the hooky lap.
I do.
The now is the cockroach, the rhubarb. We throw our nets out into the sea. All the upper lumber come swimming to me.
There we go, we go to the hooky lap. The hooky, 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 hooky lap. The hooky, 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 hooky lap.
Everybody loves the hooky lap.
Where the lala is the kakarot, the luau. We throw our nets all into the sea. All the umma umma come swimming to me. There we go, we go to the hooky lap. The hooky, 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 hooky lap.
Turn this shit off!
But that didn't stop the Bloodline from traveling across the pond and bringing their own unique brand of chaos to Backlash.
Austin, you're on the air. Good morning. We're doing open phones.
Hi, am I on the air?
Yep.
Fuck.
Thanks.
Pack, your biggest mistake of all. You questioned me. You questioned us. You asked us. You pleaded. You begged us to make you care. So we just gave you exactly what you asked for. Pack.
Who wrote this shit?
You see, as the catalyst.
Look, man, why would L.A. want to face you? When a first-round draft pick is standing right here.
Well, if I faced myself, I'd be looking in the mirror. You're talking about Logan, right?
No.
Yeah, let's get it right. Get your names right.
Look, truth is, he knows ball.
Folks doing a high-flying move?
Oh God, he's gonna throw him through. He's going on top of Jericho.
This could be the end.
Now seems a good time to bring up GaneMoore's. That's right, GaneMoore's tattoo of I am the table. I am the table on his skin forever. I asked him, and out of respect and to rip off OSW, he says his Mount Rushmore wrestlers are Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart, Scott Hall, and Steve Austin. Thank you, GaneMoore. You are the table. Ba-dum-dum.
Let me reintroduce you to me. My name is Randy Freakin' Orton. I am a 4-time, 14-time world heavyweight champion.
You are technically correct. The best kind of correct.
In a tag team contest, and oh boy, it does not take a lot for this to spill. I mean, a street fight means a street fight. And I tell you what, if you live next door, you better batten down the hatches, because the one-man armory or any number of individuals in this matchup could come bursting through the front door. Speaking of bursting, Nathan Angel just got a knife in his chop for his man now. Meanwhile, looking to tear apart the flesh of John Redmond as well. And things are getting real ugly real quick here. Now, some idiot looking to get involved, and that's exactly what you get when you step up to the plate with someone like Nero in your face.
Don't worry, folks. He'll get the help he needs.
He deserves it. Now, like I say, he's going to pay that bill.
Running through with that PK kick, and here's a cover.
I'm going to tell you one more time.
Okay.
PK kick is a misnomer.
Okay. Okay, the misnomer kick, right?
What does K in PK stand for?
I don't know. I just...
Kick.
I just, okay.
He has called it a penalty kick. Moving on.
Okay. All right. So let me write this down, and I'll send this to Excalibur. I'll just say the PK. How's that sound?
You could do that, or you could call it a penalty kick, or you could just say, what a maneuver. Here we go.
You come out to Wild Thing, but you come out to the 1984 version by the band X and not the most popular 1966 version by the Trogs. Why are you afraid of flute solos?
Could that be the Trogs?
One day, I thought they were playing Season of the Witch, but it wasn't. It was the original Wild Thing. We were filming at the Daly's place. Mm. I come out to that, and I'm like, this is weird. I don't like this at all. And I felt very, very awkward. I was like, I guess that's my music now.
So, do you prefer fluteless aggression?
Obviously paying attention to Sammy. Kick!
ってくるのか逃げずにこのディオに近づいてくるのか近づかなきゃてめえをぶちのめせないんでなほうほうでは十分近づくがよい。
You truly are the King of Kings.
Excellent.
He gives them what it is.
Yeah, Chris, that's great. It sounds great. You know what else sounds good?
Joe Hendry.
Okay, get ready. Here it comes in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Honk, honk.
You're watching it again?
This is how we play the room raids. Hidden in this room is an object. You have simply got 30 seconds to find that object. I will give you a clue, and you watch out at home for the blue arrow to tell you where it is. If you get it, you get 25 points. If you don't, the 25 points go to the other team. Is that fair?
Yeah.
Think the room will find out. This is our first race. Go for it. Look, that's coming in everywhere. Come on. Let's go, mate.
Hey, I'm just going to RKO him really bad. And then all he's going to do is cry to his little mama.
Talk about my mom, kid? You talking about my mother?
You talk about my family, man. Let's talk about your family. Oh, wait, you ain't got one because your wife divorced you and took your kids and they don't want to see your bitch ass anymore, huh?
What did you just say?
Which way that we going? This way.
We haven't had a customer in weeks. I wonder if it's the new placemats.
It's that old Patty you keep trying to sell to everybody.
Why is it in a cage?
Because it growled at me.
This was making it different. It's totally different. It's a rap song. It doesn't sound anything like theirs.
And just to prove his point,
Nintendo
breaks it down and sings the dings.
That's the way theirs goes. Ours goes. That little bitty change. It's not the same. Ours goes. Theirs goes. Little bitty change. It's not the same. Not the same. Not the same.
Flip down, maybe looking for a sunset powerbomb. Has Nia. Can she quite get her up and over?
Lyra was obviously paying attention to Sammy.
Ow! Fire hot!
The professor will help. Fire indeed hot.
And may I say, sir, you are a very lucky fellow to have in your employ such a brave, faithful, and heroic young lad. Where is he anyway?
I'm up here.
I think my sister's cute.
What?
I think my sister's cute.
Hello?
I know, I saw!
It's the time of year, now the spring is in the air, when those two wet gits with their girly curly hair make another song for moronic holidays that nauseate, in a million different ways. From the shores of Spain to the coast of southern France, no matter where you hide, you just can't escape this dance. Hold a chicken in the air, stick a deck chair up your nose, buy a jumbo jet, and then bury all your clothes. Paint your left knee green, then extract your wisdom teeth, form a string quartet, and pretend your name is Keith. Skin yourself alive, learn to speak Arapaho, climb inside a dog and behead an Eskimo, eat a Renault 4, wear salami in your ears, casserole your grand, disembowel yourself with spears. Disco is vibrating, the sound is loud and grating, it's truly nauseating, let's do the dance again. Hold a chicken in the air, stick a deck chair up your nose, yes you'll hear this song in the holiday discos, and there's no escape, in the clubs or in the bars, you would hear this song, if you holidayed in Mars. To speak Arapaho, climb inside a dog and behead an Eskimo. Now you've heard it once, your brain will spring a leak, and though you hate this song, you'll be humming it for weeks. Hold a chicken in the air, stick a deck chair up your nose, buy a jumbo jet, and then bury all your clothes.
Thanks for watching, Windjammers. I've waited 20 minutes. Here's the viewer submitted show. Calicott says, did you hear that Adam Copeland, Christian, and the Dudleys started a fund to give back to hardcore wrestlers? I think it's awfully thank you, Calicott. Thank you. Buy a shirt or don't. I don't care at this point.
Those endings were fucking shit. And you for watching Botchamania.